National Cabinet is set to meet in the next hour. State and territory leaders have a long list of topics to tackle, including international borders and caps on return travellers. 10 News First Stella Todorovic joins us now from Canberra. Good morning, Stella. New rules for returning travellers come into effect from today, yes?
That's right, Tash. Anyone coming into Australia from today will have to return a negative COVID-19 test 72 hours prior to leaving for the country. The aim of this is really to catch as many possible cases of COVID-19, and it's a bit of a stopgap as well, Tash, in hope of avoiding that more aggressive and more infectious strain of COVID-19 from coming into our quarantine system here. We have seen over the past couple of weeks, we have had some scares with that mutant strain from the United Kingdom. Now, this new rule comes into effect as National Cabinet decided a fortnight ago to cut arrival caps for international travellers. The decision then saw this domino effect and resulted in Emirates cancelling all flights to Sydney, Melbourne and Brisbane. But there is some good news this morning, Tash. Emirates will be resuming these services from next week. So less than a week since making that announcement, this is going to come as a huge relief to thousands of Australians stranded overseas for the better part of the last year. Now, National Cabinet today will also be briefed on the vaccine rollout program and how that's tracking, as well as how Australia is dealing with these mutant strains. I'm personally hoping that there will be some update on state borders. I know how frustrating that has been for so many people right across the country. And given how low the case numbers have been this week, it would probably be a welcome move for a lot of people right around the country, Tash.